These large airplanes appear to have little in common with these tiny plants, but these plants are providing a new source of fuel for aircraft. The University of Missouri is partnering with the University of Florida to discover biofuel plants that grow best in poor soils and extreme conditions. The goal is to develop a cost-effective system that will reduce U.S. dependency on foreign oil.
As you know, there is only a finite amount of petroleum in the world. It took nature millions of years to convert biomass into petroleum. Today, we do have technologies that can be used to convert plant biomass into petroleum products within a matter of minutes.
The MU agroforestry researcher is testing different varieties of switchgrass, sorghum, willows, and cottonwoods. The goal is to find out which plants or trees provide the biggest bang for the buck.
These are plants that are adapted to growing in floodplain areas. And many of these plants, they can tolerate not only flood, but they can also tolerate drought.
More than 100 million acres of land along the Missouri and Mississippi rivers are unsuitable for traditional crops due to frequent flooding and soil erosion. The MU researcher says energy crops planted on just 10% of these lands could produce 8 billion gallons of biofuel a year. The airline industry and the U.S. military recently announced plans to boost biofuel usage.
The Navy has set a target to utilize up to 50% biofuels in the next 5 years. And that means that we need to have biofuels produced in the U.S. in a sustainable way.
Many airlines and cargo operators want a third of their fuel to come from biosources by 2030. Currently, jet biofuel is more expensive to produce, but the MU researcher believes once an infrastructure's in place, it will drive down cost. Joe says the investment is worth it.
Energy security is national security.
From the University of Missouri, I'm Kent Faddis reporting.